actually going to be doing the call to prayer. Brother Walter.
But the one most qualified should lead. And if there's an imam in the crowd, then I'll bow to him. Thank you.
Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah. Ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah. Hayya 'ala s-salah. Hayya 'ala s-salah.
Downstairs to assemble for the Maghrib prayer. Those who are not going to be praying and staying in the hall, you may get your food and be seated, and we will be back to continue our program. Thank you.
Shabbat Center for all of these arduous years. We know how important this place is. This is one of our sacred places in Manhattan. And so we're always pleased and honored to house or to provide the space for the Manhattan Borough President's Iftar. It's been a few years right now. And even before she became the Manhattan Borough President, our President of New York now, Gail Brewer, used to always come up here to spend time with us in the Shabbat Center. So we welcome her, we welcome you. We pray that your Ramadan has been a fruitful one and that your Eid will be a happy one. May Allah continue to bless us all. Salam alaikum.
I just want to take the opportunity to additionally thank Jacob's Restaurant for providing dates and beverages. Thank you, Jacob's Restaurant. Who is actually Tahia Tamana and also a Stuyvesant student. So come on up, Tahia.
Thank you, Jenny, for the introduction. So this is a piece called Ami. I'm gonna begin to, it's about sincerity and it's a reflection. I'm tired. Tired of this mask I've put on to please society. I've reached the point where my anxiety has me starting to question my piety. I've lost my morality, my sense of sanity. I'm not one to preach, but when did we start letting others teach us to go against our team? When did we start taking every breath for granted? When did we forget that living isn't a breeze and start living with such ease instead of trying to seize each and every moment and make it worth something? I'm trying to breathe, but I feel like I'm drowning. All I can see are my misdeeds, slowly going away from the deen. Ya Allah, please guide me. Instead of worrying about Facebook likes, why don't we stop and think how, during just one blink, hundreds of our brothers and sisters are dying, following their beliefs. Ya Allah, please help them, Ameen. The media has malformed our thoughts and our ideas, making us question our faith. We can place our blame on them, but remember, others can load the gun, but it's up to you to pull the trigger. We're the ones who decide upon our actions and our intents, so let's not waste our time on regret.
introduce myself. My name is Islam, the root word of peace, salam, or even salama, meaning submission, which to a Muslim is his tuition. It's his ticket in. But before I begin, let me introduce myself the way I'm supposed to. So assalamu alaikum, may peace be upon you. You know, it's kind of funny. I'm accused of oppressing when really I'm oppressed. I become on the list of things to detest. I've screamed in rage in almost every protest. I've become the Red Scare, a threat to the West. You see, if you look at me and all my obligations, you'll see why I have such a great population. It's because there's the motivation and that sense of inspiration that keeps Muslim as their occupation. To me, being a Muslim means being a good person, because I'll never ask you to kill or to slay or to at least lie 5 times a day. I'll never ask you to steal or to hate or to swear or to discriminate. I actually tell you to smile at everyone you see, because the smile is the biggest sense of charity. I tell you not to smoke or to drink, to stay clean and take showers so you don't stink. I tell you to take care of animals and treat them with care. So yes, I am against animal testing and abuse, in case you weren't aware. I tell you to treat those who treat you bitter, better. I tell you not to be mad at someone for more than 3 days. I tell you to respect women and lower your gaze. I tell you that paradise lies under the feet of your mother. And I tell you to passionately love your significant other. I tell you to never mistreat your wife. I mean, if I tell you to care for animals, then what about the love of your life? I tell you to be precious and save yourself for the one, so you don't keep giving yourself away until you're literally done. I tell you to be moderate and that balance is key. Just in the middle is the perfect place to be. I tell you to excel in everything you do, from that essay to that slam dunk too. To love your brother what you love for yourself and to never hold a grudge. I tell you how to be a good person, a person of peace and a person of love. They say I'm a terrorist and extremist. And you know what? I am a terrorist. I terrorize terror. I kill injustice to make this world fairer. I am an extremist. I am extremely kind. So beware of my extreme benevolence to all of mankind. Yes, there are those who kill and bomb in my name, but if I don't approve, then why am I to be blamed? In every religion, you'll find those who abuse it, thinking they have a permit to do wrong. A religion may be perfect, but the followers may not be. So when mine commit mistakes, don't blame it on me. I give what I got, and what I got is good. So if they do otherwise, then they misunderstood. And I'm not here to preach, I'm only here to teach. I am a professor in politics, economy, and sociology. In manners and etiquette, I have my PhD. To all my teachings, I have 2 sources. The Book of God and the Word of Prophet are my resources. I teach for free, and to whoever desires to learn, it's all for the sake of Allah, and I ask nothing in return. And listen, I'm not here to convert, but just to clear misconceptions with the way I am viewed in my common perception, because yes, it hurts when I'm literally abused by some who do it for pleasure just to be amused, and by some who follow the trend because they're clearly confused. In a nutshell, my name is Islam, and everything I do goes back to salam. Peace.
And after such a beautiful piece, mashallah. So we come to the close of our program. I want to thank each and every one of you for coming out tonight, for being spectacular and good sports, considering the heat of this room. like being in Brooklyn, go to Luna Park. There is going to be a Muslim day at Luna Park in Coney Island, Avenue, Coney Island, from 10 to 6 p.m. I'm not sure if it's